Hey there, welcome in for another rousing edition of Drummer Daily. I'm Daniel. Thanks for joining me. This is episode number 183. So today's episode might be a little shorter than some of the other ones have been, especially recently. I know I've been kind of long-winded recently. But as I'm recording this, not too long ago, the Winter Olympics wrapped up. And I was feeling inspired by watching the Olympics, and I was like, you know what? My son has never seen one of the greatest movies ever made, Cool Runnings, about the Jamaican bobsled team. And it just so happens that it was on Netflix, or it is right now at least. And I was like, we have to watch this. And I hadn't seen it in a long time, so I was like, let's go ahead and watch it. So we did. I feel like every single kid, every single human being needs to watch that movie. It's a great movie. So we watched it. And if you haven't seen the movie, you should go check it out. What are you even doing right now? Stop this podcast and go watch it. But if you're not familiar or whatever, I'm not going to go into the whole plot. But basically, it's a true story about the first ever Jamaican bobsled team, and it's just like any other movie based on a true story. The general plot points are true. And of course, there's a lot of added, you know, pieces that make it more dramatic or more exciting or easier to tell as a story, as a movie. But anyway, it's basically the idea is that there are a bunch of track runners who, through some calamity, did not make it onto their summer Olympics team, and thus wanted to go to the Olympics so bad that they decided that they would form a bobsled team, and they ended up getting a coach who had done bobsled before, who happened to live in Jamaica now. And that, of course, in the movie is played by John Candy, the late, great John Candy. They convince him to coach them, and they go to the Olympics. And, of course, there's a lot of comedy ensues. But at a pivotal point in the movie, you find out that the coach, John Candy's character, previously had been basically kicked out of the Olympics or something like that because he cheated on the bobsled run. He added some extra weight to the sled to go fast. And I think the story was that at the point at which he was cheating, he had already won a bunch of gold medals and was a decorated athlete, and had already been really successful without cheating. And so the leader of the bobsled team, the driver, at one point asks him, he says, hey, you know, first off, is it true that you cheated? And the coach says, yeah, it is. And he's like, well, why? He's like, you had it all. You were already would be going down in history as one of the greatest bobsledders ever in the world. So you had it all. And then why did you decide to cheat when you already had done so much great? And John Candy's character, the coach, goes on to explain that, you know, all of that success and accolades and the achievement of all of it, even a gold medal in the Olympics, all of that, once you had it, still wasn't enough. That he still wanted more. He thought that achieving that gold medal would make him quote unquote enough in his own eyes, but he wasn't. Once he got it, he realized he still wanted more. And he said this key line that actually never hit me. I think kids probably aren't programmed to understand this stuff as much as adults are, but he said, if you're not enough without it, you'll never be enough with it. And I think that is completely true about any kind of success. And as far as, you know, since you're most likely a drummer listening to this, I want to obviously equate this back to being a drummer. And this goes towards getting a gig, or, you know, I know if you're a church drummer, maybe it's like you're trying to get on the church worship team or whatever, and you want to be able to, you know, make that worship team, or maybe you're auditioning for a band and you want to get that gig, or, you know, whatever it is, the pursuit of a goal is a noble thing, and it's a worthwhile thing. But if you are waiting for the achievement of that to make you enough in your own eyes, if your value is not going to come in until you achieve that thing, or if you're holding part of yourself back until you make that thing, you're going to discover once you get it that you're still not going to be enough. That thing will not give you the value that you're seeking. And if you remember the last episode that I posted, even if you could get all of that from achieving your dreams as a drummer, you're gonna be at risk of it being taken away from you. So even if you could, you can't get what you're looking for by achieving success. But even if you could, that success can go away, and then you're going to be right back where you started, or maybe even worse. So just remember that you've got to find joy where you are. You've got to be comfortable being a drummer, enjoy the music, enjoy playing great music. Don't wait to find the value in yourself until you achieve some level of success, because not everyone will achieve it in the same way. And even once you do achieve it, which I believe you can if you keep trying and you follow a good plan and a good path and you don't give up, I believe you can achieve that success. But even once you do, you're going to find that that you're not going to be enough if you weren't already before you got it. So just be encouraged that it is possible, but just to achieve those dreams. But just don't put all your value in that. Find your value and your worth and who you are before you get there. So I know these last couple of episodes have been very more motivational, not very specific, but I am in the next episode going to get back to your questions. I've got a great email from Rob, who plays in like a punk rock DIY scene. And so in the next episode of Drummer Daily, I'm going to answer his question about moving from playing for free as a drummer in a local scene to trying to start getting paid as a drummer. I know that's something that a lot of you have asked me about, so we're going to talk about that in the next episode of Drummer Daily. But thanks for joining me today, and we'll talk again in that episode coming up in a couple of days. Bye for now.